Hello. Hopefully you guys can hear me, even though my voice is dying. Let me get captions up and running right now. If you cannot tell, I am not feeling super great today. I'm having issues, possibly with sickness. Hi. It's fine. I'm fine. As you can tell, though, my voice is about 2 to 3 octaves lower. Thank you. I like my tree, too. Thanks, Bean. Good evening, Dave, Trev, Gamer, Jay. Thanks for hanging out. Oh, thanks, Drake. My plan is to take it easy and not prolong the sickness because I actually have a really big week. How do you spell wreaths? I feel like it's... Fuck, I need to change my... Thank you so much for hosting, Strike. You've also reminded me that I have my mean... things up. Streamlabs. And I'd like it to be the nice ones today. I was also... Oh, Jesus Christ. I was too late. Who was that? I missed it. Fuck. I'll have to refresh that. Sorry. Hold on. I'm losing my shit right now. Lord Crashington, thank you so much for subscribing. 9 months. Keep up the great work and happy holidays. Thank you. Thanks for the support. Let me change my alerts so that they're nicer. Some people like the scary ones even when it's not scary, but that's not the vibe I'm going for today. Today I'm going for the kind vibe, default. They should sound like that. That's what we want. That's the jam. Thank you for doing that. And then let me just see if these are kinder now. Good, they are. Nicer and Christmassy. Yeah. And then I have some, like, light Christmas music in the background. I'm a little sick, Master. Which is why we're doing a just chatting stream today, because this is a lot easier on me mentally and, like, physically, as opposed to, like, playing, like, a really tough platformer or something stressful that would, like, be a little rough on me today, just because I don't really feel like it. So we're gonna kind of chill, and that's why, like, just chatting is perfect for today, because I'm planning on just chilling. I have the basics of a Christmas wreath that I started yesterday. I thought maybe we could work on it. And I also need to eat dinner, so I'll probably do that. And I'm going to make myself, like, a hot toddy, because I heard that whiskey and lemon and honey are really good for your throat, so that should make me feel better. Simone is at his perch. That's where he goes to yell at the dogs that are across the street and make sure nobody comes in the house that has not been verified. So that's where my front door is, like, right there. So he can see anyone who comes up to the front of the house, and then he, like, freaks out and barks at them and stuff, which is pretty funny. Yeah, he's very protect. So I thought this would be fun. It's not a normal stream. But the last time we did a Just Chatting stream, everyone really enjoyed it, and I asked if you guys... Is he mad about something? And I asked if you guys would want to do it again, and you said yes, so... We're doing it again to see if, like, if it's still fun. He's in high alert right now. Hey, Sol. Yeah, he definitely is in the zone right now. It's the weirdest things that set him off. I did not like the last Just Chatting stream. Oh, no, James. And you highlighted it. You must feel very strongly. What... did you not like about it? Well, I mean, just chatting can bring some not savory people, but it can also bring nice new people as well. So it's nice to mix it up. So even though sometimes doing something new can cause some shakeup, it's worth it. There's action happening. He's now gone to the bottom of the stairs. Yeah, we'll just deal with it if something weird happens. Alert, alert! Come on up here. Come back up to your post, please. Go on. He's tough. Simone Silver loves you. Loves you. It's gonna be a stream. Oh, here we go. Simone, Gamer J loves you. He stopped, but he did not turn around. That's what happened. I have some Chinese that I heated in the microwave. I'm sure it's going to be super delicious. Strike Eagle, I'm gonna go give Simone pets, and I'm also going to get my food. Hey, MHawk. Thank you guys for hanging out with me on kind of a weird stream. My voice should get better over time. That's what happened last time. It typically gets better as I flex my vocal cords here. I called my, oh shoot. Stuff's going
on. OMG, down. Dave Law subbed. Dum da dum da dum.
Thanks, Dave Law. I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, MHawk got dum de dum de dum de dum. Used your messages just for the right thing. Hi from Christmas shopping. Need a break. Is it all online shopping? I got to get Simo needs pets from MHawk. And Strike Eagle gave you pets. All right. MHawk and Strike. All right. Come here, Simo. Come here. These pets are from MHawk, and these pets are from Strike. Those are his favorite pets. Little butt pets. I'll be right back. I'm turning on the water. The water boiler, the kettle. Jesus. I'm in, like, such a poor state. Simone, your wisdom loves you. You can't have any of this Chinese, though. But your wisdom loves you. He's underneath the table. He knows he's not allowed to beg, but he will be present. Oof. Buying a few kids' friends' kids' Hanukkah gifts is hard, but it is done. What makes it hard? Isn't it still just 7 days of gifts? Correct me if I'm like ignorant and dumb here, but like, isn't it just multiple gift days? Couldn't you still get them like technically the same crap? I'm all the way, Sage. I'm dying. I normally wait until we finish dreaming. I've been so lethargic. I think it's because I'm sick. I can't get myself to do anything. And I think if I didn't eat, I'd be like really dead on this stream. Like I'd be like tired and you guys wouldn't enjoy it. Cause I had to like lay down today, which is not normal. during my lunch break, instead of going to the gym, I went into the bedroom and I took an hour nap. So I've been like really drained. Hey, Timonius, thanks for subbing. 7 months.
OMG, Timonius subbed. Mary, you're the best, sick or not.
Thank you. I'm definitely sick, but I can also be of value, hopefully. I guess we'll find out. Yes, it is soy sauce. I don't need all of it though. I gotta say, I don't feel confident putting this soy sauce anywhere on this table that it won't topple over.
We'll always be friends.
Hopefully that's safe over there. Hey, okay, Bean Bandit. Simon, do you want to come up here? Thanks for using your Prime on me. I really appreciate it. Smart.
We'll always be friends forever.
Hey!
OMG Laguerre Bear subbed. General Dow. You are a bloodthirsty foe, but your chicken is delectable.
That's so funny. I definitely have like fairly generic Chinese food taste. I typically get crispy beef, which is very like generic, you know, gaijin style. And I typically get like a fried shrimp or something like that. And then fried rice, vegetable fried rice. And one of the meals came with white rice, so I have white rice in here too. So yeah, it's like crispy beef. Crispy beef came with broccoli, so at least I got a vegetable in there. I got pieces of pork in my fried rice because I'm that bitch. These are the crispy, what would you call those? Yeah, shrimps. And that's it. And there's like rice in there. It's a very boring meal. I'm very tired and I just could not cook. When I was in Japan, I called myself a gaijin a lot because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. And I definitely embarrassed myself more than once. Single pack Lego kits, bunch of less than 30 piece Marvel sets. Ooh, that sounds like a good gift actually, Silver. The great Chinese General Tsao. I'm not well. I'm not even. I can't. I've been lying to myself for 2 days. 2 days ago, I did not feel great. And I was like, it's fine. It's a sore throat. And then yesterday, my voice started to go. I don't know if you guys remember. Nina said that yesterday.
Thank you.
Was it on Native Tech? Thank you for the $10 donation. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that, Native Tech. We were playing Not So Silent Hills. Was it Friday? And she was like, maybe we'll play again on Sunday. And I was like, we'll see how I feel. And that's because I was already starting to feel a little weird. Saturday, I felt weird again. And I was like, it's fine. I'll beat it. Sunday, I lost my voice.
We'll always be friends.
Fuck.
Forever.
Straw Hat Kip. Thank you. You used your Prime. Thank you for using your Prime. Smart. Smart motherfucker. Thank you. I appreciate using it with me. I got my flu shot, Sage. Don't you fuck with me. I got my flu shot. You might not know this, but when you get a flu shot, you have 2 weeks where you are still susceptible to the flu. Also, the flu shot only prevents against so many strains of the flu. You can still get fucking sick. You just can't get, like, the strains that they have tried to get us to not have, right? So I got the flu shot, I honestly think 2 weeks ago, which means I either got the flu in that tiny 2 week window, which is bullshit, or I just got sick from something else, which totally happens. I just don't wanna, I'm not like a, I like feel very strongly about vaccinations. I'm super pro vaccination. You should all get vaccinated. If you haven't yet, do it. Don't fuck with that stuff. It's literally free. Mine was, anyway. Like, it was free. It was free 99. Can you believe that? For me to... Okay, cool. Just finally tweeting that I'm live. God. I'm gonna make this happen. We're gonna get through this, you guys. Get your damn vaccinations. This entire stream is a lie. It's literally just to make sure you guys know to fucking get vaccinated. Ugh. Anyway, you can still get sick if you get vaccinated, which is, I think, what happened to me. So yesterday I lost my voice, and I was like, I'll solve it. I'm gonna eat a lot of throat lozenges, and I did. And then today, my voice went down like 3 octaves, and I was talking to Erin, my coworker and boss, on the phone, and she was like, you don't sound good. And I was like, I don't feel very good. And I got off the phone with her, and I fucking took a nap. And then I woke up and dragged my ass out of bed, did some work, started to get ready for the stream, and I was like, there's no way I'm playing a game, because I, like, my hand-eye coordination's all messed up. I'm, like, super slow. I, like, definitely need to take it easy. So we're going to take it easy. I'm going to eat this Chinese food. I'm going to make a wreath. We're going to hang out. I'm going to read all your chat. We're just going to cheese it for an hour or two. Naps are amazing. You know, Silver, I wish I could take naps better, but the truth is, I don't nap well. If I take a nap, something's wrong with me. I nap never. I can't. I don't shut down. I sleep really well at night. I sleep 8 hours like a rock. But during the day, if I like tried to go to bed at like 1 and have like a half hour nap, I'll just sit there with my eyes closed. I can't shut down. I have like too much in my brain or something. Like I have like ADD, I think, that's just never been officially diagnosed. I have too much going on. And then when I eat dinner and I like have a couple beers, it's probably one of the reasons why I drink is because I like have a couple beers, and the beers I'm like, all right, and I'm ready to go to bed, and I go to sleep and I conk out for another day. And that's my cycle. That's my system. I have a total system, but I can't nap. But today I actually fell asleep for about 45 minutes, and that means I'm not well. If I took a 45 minute nap, I'm not well. The crispy beef is really good. The effort of laying down without falling asleep does help your body. I think I've done that before where I just like rest and I try to shut down, and it does help. I agree with you. But I can't sleep. What's wrong with my system? Hopefully there's nothing wrong. I didn't restart my computer before the stream, which I almost always do. I know better than that. Is it really delayed? Can you guys hear the Christmas music? I made it really low in case you hate Christmas music. Also, if you really don't want Christmas music, I'll turn it off. I just thought, fuck it. Okay, good. No, I never would play Christmas music before Thanksgiving. That's offensive. And there's enough of it. Frankly, I couldn't possibly. By the time Christmas rolls around, I don't want to hear that shit anymore. But for the 2 weeks, I consider it 2 weeks. Because I don't even really get into Christmas until like a week into it. You should eat. Obi-Nader, I was not paid by a Chinese food company to pimp this food, but I will tell you that it's delicious. I didn't have to cook, and I don't have to clean. I'm gonna recycle all of the packaging, and I'm gonna fucking pop my ass into bed and I'm gonna go to sleep after this. You have chimichangas? Mexican food is like my favorite. I could eat burritos and tacos and quesadillas every day and never get tired of it. Never. Nachos one day. You need gifts? Fuck, you are so late, pal. I get my shit done like months in advance. I'm very excited to play Resident Evil 3 Remake, Obi-Wan Nader. I'm fucking stoked. I can't talk about it too much because I get really excited about it. And I still have months to go. I'm in the pocket of the hole-in-the-wall Chinese place. That's right. We have a system where they give me average Chinese food in addition to me just talking about it. I think it's above average. Sorry, Trevelyan. I normally eat after I'm done streaming on Monday. I normally end my stream because I have to fucking eat. I eat a late lunch on Mondays, and then I have a little snack so I can try and make it between 9 and 9:30, but I couldn't today. I was too hungry. Ooh, Stardew Valley update. What else is in there? I honestly have not played Stardew Valley since in like a year. What replaced, Slime Rancher replaced Stardew Valley for me. Last year, I wanted to have that like fix of, you know, ranching and farming. And I got into Slime Rancher and it was so good. Hi, Mr. Yaz. Simone's sleeping behind me. Yeah, the broccoli, and this is really good. Did I ever do the RE7 DLC? I don't think so, honestly. I don't think so. I don't think I did. And we never played it in VR either, which I'd be down to do. Simone, these pets are from Wizard. Oh no, I didn't know Slime Rancher had problems on the PS4. I'm playing it on PC and I fucking love it. Oh, I haven't played it in a while, but it's very cathartic. It gives you that Stardew Valley like vibe, you know what I mean? Like where Stardew Valley just made you like zen out. Slime Rancher does that. And the music's really good. Can I handle VR? I hope so. I think what I would have trouble doing is recording Mike, recording the VR, knowing that he's okay and he's not getting like moved around on my, you know, OBS. I think if I did Resident Evil in VR, even though you guys would not appreciate this, is I would probably do it solo and not like with Mike, because it's such a technical fucking pain in the ass, VR. One of the DLC involves the uncle of the family punching the hell out of some monsters. It's quite good. Ooh, that sounds good. I don't have PSVR. I have a Vive. I think you can see it. It's on my roof. There it is. Oh, Simone, stop. For God's sakes. Oh, I'll put him on the stream so you guys can see him. Paranoid. Simon's very paranoid today. He loves getting pets, but he loves protecting me most of all. Which side should I go on? I'll go on this side. This is closer to my food anyway. And then Simon can. Yeah, it makes more sense. So, yeah, I have a Vive. And I was hoping I could play the new Half-Life with it. I didn't know if I needed a PlayStation or it's an Oculus to play the new. Half-Life game. The Vive should work. Okay, good. Because I'm obviously not as crazy as everyone else about Half-Life. It's got some really big fans, but I was a huge fan of Half-Life 2, and I've been looking forward to any news for years, and like most of us, I think I gave up hope long ago and just kind of let it go. So when I heard about possible Half-Life, I got really, really excited. I got my hypes, like hopes set up really high, and Yeah, when I heard it was in VR, I got really sad because I was like, first of all, I don't even know if I can play this. And then second of all, like, now it's very restrictive. But you have to remember that, like, they are known for, like, crazy innovation with their titles. Like, Half-Life did things that no game had ever done before. And I think the reason they're doing this in VR is because it's the same thing where they're going to do shit that's, like, future game, you know? Stuff that you're not going to see for, like, 10 more years, right? It's just, like, in, they, like, sense this stuff and it's going to be important later. Hey, Draco. Sorry, I am Sikh, so I'm slow. It did kill Valley of the Gods, maybe indirectly. And who knows? You just don't know a lot about this stuff. Like, maybe that game was struggling. Maybe the developers were having financial troubles and, you know, they were saved. We just don't really know the ins and outs of that whole situation. But I am sad because I was looking forward to Valley of the Gods because I really liked Firewatch. Despite the fact that I was a little disappointed with the story, I feel like I'm the only asshole who says that. Everybody talks about Firewatch as like this crazy good game, which it is stunning. And holy shit, I've never seen first person rock climbing look so good. But I just didn't think the story ended like in a very satisfying way for me anyway. I was not satisfied with the ending of that story. I am glad I played it. No regrets. No, I have not seen that video of a little boy watching the ending of Half-Life 2 for the first time. Why is it sad? Just that he's, like, sad about, like, the ending itself, or sad because he's like, where's the next game? Let's play it. And they're like, there isn't anymore. You do get a turtle, Bean. I heard they didn't cancel Valley of the Gods. I heard they put it on hold. As far as what I heard, and I could be wrong, they had an article that said, not canceled, on hold, indefinitely. Which is basically like canceling it, but it's not the same. Not the same. Hi, Goob! Thank you. This is a video game of a sick girl eating Chinese food. It's made by the people who made Firewatch. What am I eating? I'm eating Chinese food, leftover Chinese food from this weekend. It's got fried rice, white rice, crispy beef, fried shrimps, some pieces of pork, and some broccoli. And I'm going to eat it. On hold. I'm glad they were honest. That is Simone's butt. Thank you, Goob. You have a good eye. Game is trash. Goob, you're trash. I am a little sick. I'm a little under the weather. Thank you. Ooh, my phone is updating. Hey, KT. Thanks for following. I just realized today, too, who told me? Let me check my Twitter. I was informed today of a new we got 9,000 followers since Simone just farted. I don't know if you can hear that. Fuck, he's so funny. It's like light, but I know it when I hear it. I'm looking. Damn it, now I can't find it. We got 9,000 followers on Twitch, and I'm really proud of it. I'm so slow. So we should celebrate. We should celebrate that and Simon farting in my living room. Stamps, thanks for the bits. I appreciate that. You know, I thought I had a animation for bits. It's weird. Yeah, I think 9,000 is good. And you know what else? Oh, good for you, Super Smash Snake. I'm so close to beating Luigi's Mansion. I'm on the final floor, so I have the 15 button, and I haven't gone up to 15 yet. Because I've been collecting little knickknacks. What's wrong with the captions? RPG, if you don't like them, they're on close. There's like a little CC button, and you can just press that and they'll go away. Hi, Yell Dead Cell. Ooh, that's a tongue twister. Yell Dead Cell. Yell Dead Cell, Yell Dead Cell, Yell Dead Cell, Yell Dead Cell. Yell Dead Cell. Yell Dead Cell. Streel. I feel like I can say that one. Streel 99, Streel 99, Streel, 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 Streel 99. This is good for me. Journey to the Savage Planet. Yeah, Simon farted. He farts all the time. I can't believe, Wizard, it's one thing to be like, control's not for me, but fuck control? It's pretty aggressive. It's a staunch view. It's fighting words is what it is. I respect your opinion. It ate my equipment. What do you mean it ate your equipment? Star Wars leaks are happening. Oh, fuck. Why does everybody ruin everybody else's joy? I'm not as big of a Star Wars, like, hardcore person, but my best buddy, Josh Shaw, is, like, wicked into Star Wars. I couldn't imagine ruining something like that for him. It deleted your weapon mods. That's bullshit. That sucks. Sage. Fuck your equipment. That sucks. Hey, Josh! I was literally just talking about you. Weird. We're just saying that there's Star Wars leaks in chat. We were talking about how apparently there's Star Wars leaking. Super Smash Steak was saying. I would actually like to know what Katrina thinks about my wreath, although I've literally just begun, and I'm also eating. I'm sick, Katrina. Leave me alone. So here's what I have so far. This is inspired by Katrina. That's Josh's fiance. She's awesome. Katrina, do you have an account or do you just talk through Josh? Katrina rules. She's really fun. And she was like making wreaths. She was making them with like a wire. I didn't have that. So I got a, what do you call that? Fuck, this is really gonna push me. The wooden circle in which you would stitch in. Whatever the fuck that's called. I talk through my assistant, Josh. cool. Well, at least you can hear me directly. So I've started the process. These are, I don't know. These are like, they smell good. These are pieces of scrap tree. I went to a tree farm with Nina and Jake. They bought a tree and I literally packed a bag, a paper bag, filled with these little scraps. And then I got some holly. Ooh. And some ribbon and like some other, you know, crap. I have this like ball. I think they're called ornaments, you know. Anyway, I was gonna like a wreath. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm not crafty like you are. They're real tree parts. It's the real deal. Thank you, Kia. Oh, Cell, thanks for subbing. 7 months. Dope.
OMG, Cell Processing subbed. Hey, Mary. Merry Christmas. I understand the redundancy of that sentence.
I hear a lot of Merry Kishmas this time of year. Oh, he's upset. Someone's walking their dog on the sidewalk. He doesn't like that. I have to say, having this window and this couch has been so good for Simone. I know sometimes he's like annoying because he's protective, but I think it's been really good for him mentally. Like, he's always got stuff to look at and yell at. When we were in San Francisco, I feel like he was always kind of just in a studio apartment, walking around a square. He goes on really long walks now, and I don't know, he's good. I think this is a better system for him. It gives him something to do. You're out. Thank you, Strike. I don't put in any effort. God bless you, Kia, for saying that, but I'm telling you, I really don't put that much in. Oh, Stamps wants me to pet him. All right, let's see. Simone, these pets are from Stamps. He's in the zone. He doesn't want it. Gamer J. These pets are from Gamer J. Done. He's like, I'm trying to protect our house. Stop touching me. Katrina, what do you think? Out of 10. And let me ask you this, Katrina, now that I have you here. Was I supposed to, like, braid these or some shit? Like, am I supposed to do something to make them look better? Or do they just hang there? Hey, Hulk Hunter, I'm doing okay. I'm, like, I'm mentally a little slow because I'm a little sick today, but I'm in good spirits, and I'm, you know, morale is high. Was I supposed to do crafts or something? Where's your wreath, Jordan? We're making Christmas wreaths today. Everybody get in. Josh isn't posting anymore. They're gone. They've left me. Standard. They just stopped in for a second to make fun of my shitty wreath. Katrina had this, like, green wire on hers. And I remember I actually bought green wire because I made fucking a money bouquet for my girlfriend, Amarise, for her birthday. And I was like, I have all this green stuff already. I have green tape and I have green wire from making Amarise's birthday present. Did I ever tell you guys that? I don't know if I told anybody that. I literally, for Amarise's 33rd birthday, because Amarise is, she's very particular. She knows what she likes, and I love that about her. And the best thing to honestly give her is fucking money, because she'll spend it on something she wants. So I took a bunch of $5 bills and turned them into flowers, and I gave her a bouquet that was like $60, and I was like, go buy whatever you want with it. Buy whatever game you want or makeup or whatever, because you know what you want. It was a great gift and it looked really cool. Another reason I don't like just chatting is talking to the chat. If I get missed or ignored, I get depressed and I can leave. But if it's only one of the other streams.
Wildcard subbed. My wife is yelling at me to tell you it's an embroidery hoop that you are using.
Wild card and your amazing wife. Embroidery hoop is what it's called. Thank you for letting me know. Embroidery hoop, that makes sense. That's right. Because it came with two, because you put one in the other one. Embroidery hoop. Thank you. And thanks for subbing, and thanks for using your sub to correct how stupid I am. I should probably go back to this. James, I'm really sorry. I feel bad. I think, to be fair, I feel like I interact with chat more when I do just chatting than when I play video games because I actually have time to read it, and I'm like, that's literally the point of this stream is to just read chat and talk to you. But I do think that it can be exhausting because there's so much going on that it can feel like it's just like a mess, like the Wild West out here. And I don't think that's fun, right? Like, I don't think anyone feels like it's fun to, like, spam chat and hope that it gets noticed. That's not cool either. So I think that stinks, and that's why I won't do it all the time. Just chatting is meant to, like, kind of shake up the content a little bit. Fuck, that scared me. You know, just
shake it up. So don't expect to do it too much. Just like my Just Dance streams. I like doing Just Dance, but I don't do Just Dance like all the time because it's exhausting. So I try to do it, you know, once in a while. Hi, how are you? I'm new here. Hope you're having a big day. Do you do TikTok? Hulk Hunter! Thank you for highlighting your message. I think I've done one talk. I am behind on the talks. I was behind on the snaps as well. I don't do them all. I should get more into TikTok, but I don't. But I have a TikTok. I'm pretty sure it's just my name. But I think I've only like really done like two talks. Swear to God. I should do more. What do you want Santa to bring you for Christmas, Mary? A Super Smash Snake. I have asked for a couple things. This is ugly, but I'll show you. But don't judge me. Those are my Christmas presents. Can you see them by my base? So my mom got me some of these and my dad. And then I have some other gifts over here. I asked for really boring things like silverware that matches because all my silverware is mismatched from like six different sets that I got, you know, somewhere at resale probably. Hi, Rooney the Dwarf. Kesha had a TikTok. Oh, Sel, thanks for hosting me. What is your TikTok name? All right, let me find out. I got a TikTok account. I did. I remember. My phone is starting. It was like updating. I will tell you. Hulk, I'm going to look it up as soon as I do it. I had a Snapchat. I literally deleted my Snapchat. Silverware works, but I was like, my parents were like, what do you want? And I was like, I don't know. I have everything I need. I'm very blessed. I'm very fortunate. I have a job that allows me to pay for things that I really need. And I'm also very frugal because my mom taught me that. So like this couch is like 6 years old, but it works. It's not broken. So I'm not going to buy a new one. So I like, if I need something, I buy it. I'm very independent. And then I've also been very fortunate because my streams have been doing well. So my video games are almost, I would say 100% paid for by stream donations and subs. So all the subs and all the donations, they go into buying the games for my streams. Or just for me to like play for a hot minute. Games are expensive, as we all know. $60 game goes really quick. And sometimes I literally play a game for, you know, like 2 hours. Then I'm like, nah, I don't like it. I do that a lot. Barefoot deadlifts. No! Rooney, that's nuts. I should have my friend send it to me. He took a video of me. I deadlifted 200 pounds. I beat my deadlift max, like literally 2 days ago. I'm very impressed. But yeah, silver, it's like, you don't need matching silverware. I just, I was like, it's something I could have and I would take it. I've never deadlifted bare feet. I didn't even know that was a thing. I gotta say, it freaks me out a little bit, only in the sense that like, I like stuff covering my feet. I guess my shoes wouldn't protect me if 200 pounds fell on my toe, but it'd be better than if I was, you know, bare tootsied. Hi, Legendator. We're just hanging out today. Nothing exciting. I'm looking up my TikTok name because I'm trash. Let's see. Okay. TikTok. Okay. I have it. The app exists. I told you. Sorry, Hulk. I didn't tell you yet because I'm... Oh, my God. Oh, my gosh. This is such a bad profile. You don't want to see this. This is garbage. All right. My name is Mary Kish, too, but it's spelled the way my real name is spelled. How confusing is that? Can you see this? There's no way you're going to be able to see this. I'll just type it in chat. Yeah, thank you, Jordan. It's Mary Kish, too. What Jordan Mallory put. Fuck, it's so bad, though. The content's garbage. There's like five videos on here.
And none of them are good.
Wow.
You can really oh no, there's TikToks are happening.
Wow.
I had to get rid of them. It was Terry Crews flashing his boobs. Alright. I've dicked around enough. I'm gonna tie this to here. Will TikTok still be here? So I heard some bad stuff about TikTok. I heard they suppressed content from people who are like disabled and overweight, which is pretty bullshit. They admitted it. I can't believe Katrina isn't watching the stream anymore to yell at me about my wreath. She was like, I'm not gonna watch her eat. That's weird. But I disagree. It's cool. Terry Crews is positive. He's also a huge advocate for sexual, like, I don't know if assault, but like, you know, unwanted touches. Because he got unwantedly touched at a party and he called the dude out. And he's been fighting it, like, in court and everything. Much to the chagrin of, like, the producer. And he's been shamed for it. Isn't that bullshit? Yeah, he did. I promise. I remember. And other men have, like, made fun of him, which really pisses me off. Basically being like, men can't, like, be assaulted. Just punch him in the face. And Terry was like, no, like, you just shouldn't, that shouldn't happen. Yeah, he's so confident that he, like, talks about it openly, and he's like, it's bullshit. I was like, I think he has got his, like, butt, like, grabbed or something at a party, and probably his groin or something by, like, some, like, creepy producer. And he, like, called him out publicly and was like, that guy's a shitty, creep person. And the producer basically, like, called him a liar. And then a bunch of other men publicly, like, made fun of him. It's bullshit. He's like super cool and strong. I'm amazed. Would you imagine? You should put up your tree, Kia. I believe in you. Yeah, grabbed him in the crotch. I promise. I read about it. I was like, what? Anyway, he handled it really well. So that's what a lot of people are saying, right? Is like, why don't you just like beat the shit out of him? And it's like, because he's like a really... He's, like, a really well-known producer, and he's, like, really well-known in the industry. And Terry was like, if I punched, like, a rich, well-known white producer, what do you think would happen to me? I'd get assault charges, and it could ruin my career. This guy assaulted me. He's the fucking fuck. He should be in trouble, and that's what happened. That's, like, kind of the story, right? Is, like, if he punched him, would people believe that he was, like, grabbed, or would people be like, Terry Crews was drunk and, like, punched some guy, right? So Terry didn't punch him and tried to, like, take it to court, and he fucking sued him. It's interesting. Yeah, and it's, like, it's just, like, one of those, like, complicated things. Is Elon, do you want to come up here? He's sitting on my feet down here, but why don't you come over here? He wants to sit down here. Feels very strongly about it. It kind of like, it continues the cycle of violence, right? Which is like, you know, if a guy's being like, you know, weird and grabbing you, you just like beat the shit out of him. And it's like, that's actually not maybe the best solution. The best solution is to educate him. And then if you have to like shame him into like realizing he shouldn't, you can't touch people without their consent. But even, like, Terry Crews got shit for it. It's bullshit. He did get a points treat. Thanks, Jordan. Where's my treats jar?
We will always be friends forever.
I'm coming back! Ugh, what's that? Stamps! You gifted a sub to Gamer J. That's so nice. Thank you so much. Stamps, thanks for doing that. Gamer J, I hope you enjoy your C-motes. That's awesome. Very Christmas spirity of you.
You got an emote thanks to Stamps' gift. Whoa, I got another emote. Stamps, thank you. That's actually a huge deal. I literally just got a new emote because of that. Come on up. Can I see who redeemed this? All right, this treat has been redeemed. Is it Gamer J? There you go. Pets are nice. Everybody likes a good pet. All right, I'm gonna eat. I have not worked on this wreath for very much. What was I gonna say? I was gonna say Kia. This tree is fake. It's like this big and it's basically already lit with lights. All I do is put like 5 ornaments on it. It takes like no time. Silver, you wanna convince Nina and Jake to get a pet? I literally kind of hinted at it the other day. It's funny you say that. Why do you want them to get a pet? Nina's addicted to like, or sorry, Nina's addicted. She's allergic to like fucking everything. She gets really bad allergies with dogs. The only reason she doesn't get them with Seamum sheds a lot, is like before she comes over, I vacuum and I like wash the sheets like all the time so that she doesn't get hay fever. And she said when she comes over, she still gets it a little bit. It's just not that bad. Guinea pigs look nice. I told her maybe a bunny. What do you think about a bunny? Apparently cats are harder than dogs in terms of allergies, so she probably can't get a cat. There's dogs that almost have no hair. Stamp superior, I respect that opinion. You have to be really careful with getting a dog if you can't handle it. I am not proud of this, but I will admit to you that I had a dog in college and I had to give him up because I got 2 jobs and the dog was in a cage for like 12 hours a day. And so I had to find a home for him. And I gave him to a mom and a little boy who loved him. And it was really hard and I was like a fucking wreck from it. But I couldn't. It wasn't right to have a dog in a cage for that long. The dog was in a cage like all day. I was working doubles all the time. And no one was happy. Everyone was miserable. The dog was miserable. The dog was ruining the house because he wasn't getting any attention. I was miserable because I was working and working and working. I'd come home and like pet it while I fell asleep. No one won. So I found a good home for him, and I'm still friends with the people I gave him to. She gives me updates online every once in a while about how he's doing. He was a beagle. He was nuts. He was, like, super energetic. It was madness. So it was really tough for me, and my lesson is please don't get a dog unless you're, like, ready for that kind of commitment. Because Simone is a huge commitment. He's a huge... huge commitment, both financially and in terms of money. I would love to show you guys how much I fucking deal with on a daily basis for his allergies. It's absurd. He cost me so much money. This is true. He cost me so much money. This year, we maxed out his fucking insurance premium. They won't pay any more out. Thank God it's December. I maxed out his insurance claims. And I pay $35 a month for insurance and $250 deductible. And then he costs so much money. I want to say maybe like $5,000 or something this year. He had so many allergies and he got bit by that dog. The bite was a big one. That one cost a lot of money. But it was all covered in my insurance. I would love to tell my dog to deal with his allergies, but they, like, result in, like, welts on his skin, and I feel really bad. I agree, Gamer J. It is worth it in the end. My pit bull has crazy allergies. I feed him grain-free organic food, and he still gets itchy. I also give Simone, like, top-of-the-line allergy, like, allergen food. He gets a soy-based diet with meat sprinkled in, obviously, because I think he needs, like, you need, like, protein from, like, legit meat. So I think he gets, like, duck liver and, like, other things. But it's very cultivated by our vet. And he still gets allergies a lot. Thanks, Bean Bandit. I like, love my dog. He is the light of my life. I do everything for him. He's my child. But he takes a lot of effort and a lot of fucking money. So I would not recommend a French bulldog to almost anyone. And people all the time stop me on the street and they're like, he's so cute, I want one. And I'm like, just so you know, he costs me a shit ton of money. He's very difficult. If Simone could talk, what do you think his voice would sound like? I think he would sound... Sometimes I do talk for him. What noise do I make for him? It's probably, like, annoying, like, but endearing. Like, give me the treat, Mom. I haven't gone out in 3 days, Mom. Sick of this shit, Mom. It's kind of like a little 8-year-old boy. A little brat. Like, I kind of envision him, like, kind of chunky, like a chunky 8-year-old boy who's, like, always got, like, a sucker in his mouth. And he's like, Mom, I'm hungry. I'm like, shut up. I love you, but shut up. Steven from Steven Universe. Oh, my God. He might sound like that. Steven from Steven Universe is, like, a sweetheart, though. You put enzymes on wet dog food. That's good. We do not deserve dogs. Grain-free diets are real bad for dogs, leading to heart failure. Oof, there's so many things you have to watch out for. Like mine's mostly soy-based, but we change it all the time. Salmon-based. So I also used to put, Simone was on 6 fish, which was like what he used to be on, which was 6 fish, 6 types of fish. We did that for a while. He still got allergies on that too. He sounds like Kermit. Oh my gosh. I love Kermit, actually. Thank you. John Benjamin. Bart Simpson. Maybe, yeah, he's a little brat like that. He's definitely got an attitude like that. English accents. He's a thick boy. 16 years without health issues? Pardalis, that's probably like the most lucky I've ever heard. Bill Murray. Wasn't Bill Murray the voice for Garfield? Such a funny thing. Yeah, he's Cartman. Ma'am! Bathroom! It kind of is what he does, too. He yells at me for bathroom. Bobby from King of the Hill. These are all really good. I like that one, too. Just a chubby kid. It's like sussing it out. Where do we put the tree? Do you have a window? Fuck, I'm sorry. I shoved mine in the window. It does look good in there too, though. I have a couple other things. I have some stockings hung up, and I have my Pikachu wreath that I love. Fozzie Bear, oh my god. A bear in its natural habitat. A Studebaker. It's like one of the very few lines I remember from The Muppets Go to Hollywood or whatever. Dilbert. The window is blocked by the couch. Ah. The kitchen, we had a table, but it's an island now. This is tough. Venkman. Ooh. You want to see the Pikachu wreath? I'll get it for you. It's hung up, but I'll take it down just so you can see it. It's really cute. Well, that was hard to take down. It's got a little bell on it. And it's got Pikachu, kind of, I guess he's Santa, because he's got a Santa hat and he's got a little bag full of goodies. It's really cute. I like it a lot. I'm so weird about it. I won't hang it outside because I'm like terrified that someone will steal it or it'll get ruined. So it literally stays in my living room. Mr. Dreadful, thank you for subbing. Ooh. I'm excited. Thank you very much for the support. I'm gonna treat myself to a piece of shrimp. I'd definitely steal that. I love it. Mr. Dreadful, you got a gift sub. Shrimps are tasty. I want to become a pescatarian, but I can't deny myself anything. I could never diet. I love eating food. So the idea of like never eating like pork or beef again really stresses me out. But I'm very conscious of the way they treat animals and I don't like eating meat. So I try to eat a lot of fish. And I do. I eat a shit ton of fish. And, you know, sea animals. And meat substitutes are getting better every day, aren't they? Yes, Bean. I love the Impossible Burger. I'm a huge advocate for the Impossible Burger. So fish are animals. And, you know, I don't know. I'm not going to, like, go to war over this. But I would argue that they're more sustainable than land animals. So, you know, the cost to our environment for keeping a fish alive and killing it so that we can eat it is not the same as a cow, which is, like, just an enormous amount of water. It takes a lot of land. It takes a lot of grain. So the food that they feed the cow to make the cow grow up so that you can kill the cow so that you can eat the cow costs way more than fish. Also, debatable. Some people argue that fish don't have like the same pain receptors. Obviously, they don't want to fucking die. That's why they try to jump back in the water, but they're not like feeling pain in the same way. 50% American land is cows. Holy shit. I dialed back my pork and my beef substantially. I do once a week or less with pork and beef. And chicken, even. Seafood I'll do all the time. All the fucking time. Hey, Australian alien. Christmas is going well. I'm making a wreath, kind of. I eat a lot of vegetables. I make a lot of salads. I make veggie fried rice. I make vegetarian laksa. Laksa is a weird one. I learned that in Australia. It's basically coconut curry. It's delicious. I do curry. What else do I make? Chicken or assholes. I eat chicken sometimes. I eat a lot of turkey. I eat ground turkey, which is totally a land animal. I agree with that. I eat ground turkey in the form of, like, you know, meatballs and tacos and stuff like that. I'm about to get a fork and just shovel this in my face. Like a piece of shit. Oh yeah, the Impossible Burger. I've heard this. My dad told me this too. Yeah. the Impossible Burger isn't better for you food-wise. There's tons of fat in there to keep it together and it uses a lot of energy to make it, but it isn't meat, so ethics-wise, if it's your goal, it's better. Yeah, so there's two major things that are better with the Impossible Burger. One is ethically, right? Nobody died. Nothing was hurt to make it. But two, it is better for the environment because the amount of resources that it takes to grow a cow and keep the cow, like, fed and watered before you kill it. So you are correct that it's not healthier. But in my mind, if I were to have a burger, and I don't know if you guys have had the Impossible Burger, but I can't fucking tell. It's delicious. If I am craving, like, a big, fat, juicy burger, and I can have it be vegetarian, which means no animal was killed, and it's much better for the environment, I've already, like, kind of decided that I'm eating unhealthy food. I'm having a burger, for God's sakes. Like, I know it's not good for me. Like, I'm not pretending this Chinese is good for me. It's fucking super bad for me. But if I can make it more eco-friendly, I would. I don't think there's any Chinese place that's trying to figure out health, though. The texture is only slightly off. It's definitely not the exact same, but I would say it's good enough. It's enough for me. And they're still perfecting the process. They tried to kill the Impossible Burger because the meat industry wants us to eat meat. Obviously. That was really good. Meat kofta kebab. Yeah, I feel strongly that it's worth trying, and it's even worth not stressing over. Like, if it tastes not exactly the same as a burger, but it's so much better for the environment and nothing died, I'm gonna take that veggie burger. My Christmas is going splendidly too. I'm currently in the Philippines with my other relatives over there, so that's why I'm not here. I also don't have great internet. The internet will change things. Well, Merry Christmas from the Philippines. That's cool. Do you still celebrate? You guys still doing the usual things, or does it change it? I'm making a wreath. Here's my progress pick. Since starting the stream, I've put one branch on here. I have done so little. Vegan chicken. That sounds good. Black bean burgers. I've had those. I'm not that in love with beef. It's good. I mean, it's good. It's good. It's better to not eat a lot of beef for your, like, health. I just think it tastes good, but... Boca's meatless stuff all the time. It tastes nothing like real meat. Yeah, I resign myself to the fact that I know it's not going to taste exactly the same. The Impossible Burger is the very first time I've ever been, like, tricked. I didn't know if it was meat or not. I couldn't tell. Vol, Mary, going to San Francisco in a week. What restaurants would be best? Been trying to find recommendations. Well, are you looking for kind of, like, street meaty, like, not super expensive? Or are you looking for, like, fancy places to go, because San Francisco is filled with really wonderful restaurants. A place that's not, like, wicked expensive that I think is so phenomenally good is, what's it called? Hold on, I got it. It's got a weird name.
It's got like kimchi in the name or something.
Fuck. How can I forget this? Hold on. I'm gonna think of it. Umami burger is so good if you like burgers. Now I feel stupid. What's that fucking place called? It is a burrito place in SF.
Thank you.
Oh, Taqueria. But it's spelled different. Like, it's not Taqueria like a Taqueria. It's Taqueria like Korea, the country. Taqueria. And it mixes, it's Korean-Mexican fusion, so it has kimchi in the burritos. Free shivakadu! And thank you. Thus, Windburns spelt it correctly in the chat. Taqueria. It, like, so it's not with a K, it's with a C, I guess. That's weird. Anyway, they do something called, they put tater tots in their fucking burritos, and it's so good. But even if you don't get the burrito, you can get, I get like the tater tot. I think it's kind of like nachos, but instead of nachos, it's tater tots. And it's covered with like bulgogi meat and then all the fixings of like delicious Mexican food. It's so good. Yeah, it's really good. It's super bad for you. It's delicious. So I recommend Taqueria. I used to go there all the effing time. Where else did I go? Pixel, eat something. Order something. Get DoorDash. Live your life. I don't know why I can't think of the places that I liked. I just took my last bite of dinner and you're making me hungry. Yeah, there's lots of good food there. Where else did I used to eat? I'll just tell you the places I ate out a lot. I went to White Horse a lot, but I don't know if I can recommend that. The only reason I went there a lot is because they have really, really cheap chicken wings. And I used to be able to get, like, the chicken wing sampler is, like, $15. And it's a shit ton of wings. And you could split it with another person. So you can eat, like, a full dinner plus two beers for, like, $20, which you cannot fucking do in San Francisco to save your ass. It's called White Horse Inn. And they just have totally decent chicken wings. They're not like the greatest, but they're totally decent. It's fine. It's hard to describe. Oh, I got distracted again. Let me go to ramen. There's a lot of good ramen places. I like Ramen Yamadaya. It's in Japantown. But a lot of people would argue with me and say go to like Boxer Ramen or a Furry or one of those other ones. But anyway, I go to Yamadaya because it's in Japantown. It almost never has like a wicked long line. And I think their ramen is really good. And I go there a lot. You can get really good ramen in San Francisco. Your girlfriend is going to plan a trip there and you can pick stuff. Cooked salmon is your favorite food. I like cooked salmon too. I'm telling you, it's really cheap. It's hard to feed two people with $20. So the other day I went to a taco truck in Portland and we each got three tacos and I got a Mexican Coke and the total for both of us was $13. And it was like, we were done. We were like full after that. I have not fed two people lunch for $13 ever. I was like, this is amazing. A Mexican Coke is a Coke in a glass bottle made with sugar cane, not corn syrup. It's made in Mexico. That's true, Gamer J. But the main distinction is that all Coke made in America is made with corn syrup. Actually, almost everywhere in the world now, because the Corn Farmer Association of America had all the sugar changed from sugar cane, which was outsourced because we don't really grow sugar cane in America. We get it from like other countries and import it. they changed it to corn syrup because it was saving the farmers. Like, farmers needed to sell corn, so they turned it into corn syrup. Sugarcane is more common in America soda again. When? It's always syrup. Everywhere I go, it's syrup. I don't know about that. Are you talking about, like, fountain soda? It's all syrup. If you get a soda out of a fountain, it's fucking made with corn syrup. Sugarcane, Dr. Pepper in Texas. So, yeah, you can get the sugar versions, but, like, most of the time it's definitely high fructose corn syrup. It tastes better, 100%. And you can taste it. I promise you, you'll be able to taste it. Movie Trivia Daily. Hi! Okay, so from Willy Wonka, what happens to Violet when she chewed the three-course gum that wasn't ready? Well, the first two courses were fine. I think she tasted like, I want to say it was like a dinner. It was like meatloaf or something. But then the third course, it was like blueberry dessert, and she turned into a blueberry. She like got blue and she expanded into a big circle, and the little guys had to roll her out the door. Blueberry, final answer. I never get to do trivia. This is fun. Violet, you're turning violet. Yay, you're right. Oh, good. That made me feel really good. Crazy Jeff. Feed Simon. Simon! I wish I did trivia more often. I really don't do it very often because I always panic under pressure. It could be like something I'm super aware of and know really well, and I'd still do it wrong. Simone, this treat is from Crazy Jeff. Can you shake for it? Lots of safety concerns with Wonka. I feel like his factory would not survive our legalese. I don't know if they died. What do you remember most about that blueberry scene? Probably the Oompa Loompas rolling her out the door. Are we talking about the original? Because I think I have more memories associated with the original than with the new one, frankly. But I remember them rolling her out the door. And is that not the same scene as when Charlie stole the everlasting gobstopper and put it in his pocket and, like, kept it from everyone? That thieving little rat. I can't remember. And I think I also remember from that scene, to eat the three-course meal gum, she took out the gum she already had and put it behind her ear. And she had been chewing that piece for, like, years or something, which is so gross. Thank you. It's an Australian opal. I really like this necklace. TV room has a teleporter that could shrink anything to an inch they could fit on a screen. Oh, yeah. No one talk about the remake. I didn't think it was very good. I don't think that's news. I think a lot of people were disappointed with it. It lacked the luster. He stole the fizzy drink? I thought he stole the everlasting gobstopper. I'm probably right. I would not... would I have chewed the three-course meal gum? I honestly don't think I would touch many things in that factory unless Willie told me I could. Because it's, like, a little weird. Also, the whole factory, like, it was after the scene where everything was edible, like, the candy grass and the chocolate river and all that stuff. Like, I would have eaten enough candy that I think I would have contained myself. If it was the first room, maybe. Because if it's the first room, you're kind of like trying to get it. But we'd already had the candy grass and stuff. And the kids were like eating like the mushroom marshmallow goo, and he was given the everlasting gobstopper. I trust movie trivia daily. Like, I don't know if that's true, but I believe them. I give them carte blanche because their name is Movie Trivia Daily. So I assume that they know more than me about this movie. Not being negligent. I like Depp as an actor, but there's no way to improve on Gene Wilder. Gene Wilder really did ride the line between, like, I don't really like kids, but I also love kids, but I also don't like them. He, like, just had a really good mellowness to him. And I liked how he kind of, like, they made that meme about him, like, making fun of them, being like, oh, you do? Oh, you do have it really hard? And he's just, like, he, like, really captured the essence of that character where he was just making fun of children most of the time. But he did it so delicately. Johnny Depp is not my favorite actor, personally. I don't think that he is my cup of tea. Most of the time I see him in a role, I just feel like it's a little overdone, frankly. I don't think he's that great. I also don't think he's that great of a person. He's got some pretty bad stories about his relationships and the way he treats his wife and ex-wife and girlfriends, so I think he can get fucked. Anyway, I like Tim and Eric too. I don't know. I mean, I'm eating, so I guess when everyone's bored of me not doing anything and dicking around, we'll end it. I don't know if I ever loved him. That's the thing. I don't think I ever loved him. I did like the Pirates of the Caribbean? Which one is right? I liked him in that. But then those movies got, like, weird and, like, redundant. So. Did you know they've written articles about him? All his movies are, like, totally bad at the box office. His last 10 movies have, like, completely bombed at the box office. It's weird. Simone. I'm gonna fucking butcher this. Bolsonika loves you. Loves you. The rum! That was a good one. I haven't seen Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. I want to see it. I would see that. I liked Edward Scissorhands. I like how everyone's just saying things they like now. I like Michael Cera. I like Scott Pilgrim. What else do we like? I like bubble tea too. There's a close bubble tea to this place and it's really dangerous. Doom 2 isn't out, unless you're talking about the original. I want to see Knives Out. I haven't seen it yet. It took me ages to see Parasite. No spoilers about Knives Out. Besides that it's awesome, which I've heard. Maybe that's what I'll do this weekend. I like breathing. I like Jamie Lee Curtis. She's great. I like Totino's. I know they had a party pizza. I do pizza rolls. If you spoil Knives, I will ban you. End this stream and go see Knives Out. I'm not gonna see it now because I'm sick, but I will see it. I'll see it this weekend or something. Chris Evans has a good sweater. I loved Parasite. It's very, very good. It was not what I thought. I like tech. I like tech too. Party pizza is their pro tier pizza. Fold them in half and eat it like a taco. What the fuck? Isn't that just a calzone? Parasite was heavy. Yeah, it's really stressful. I feel like I didn't breathe in it. I was constantly like... I like calzones. I like hiking in the mountains. I like hiking too. I like hiking with my dog. If I can't take Simone, I feel like it's a waste. Ghost Stories anime? What does that mean? Is that a very specific anime? Or do you like anime that it's about ghost stories? Oh.
I like trash pizza from like a frozen section. I haven't seen it. Is it on Crunchyroll? Ooh, I like Sour Patch Kids. This is one of my favorite candy. I like Trash Mary.
Calzones also remind me of Parks and Rec. What's that character's name? He was so funny. Jaeger Me, thank you for subbing. 4 months! Thank you so much for so much support. I really appreciate that. Thank you for hanging out with me for so long. I like a lot of basic bitch food. Same. It's a mood. Demon Slayer on Hulu. I haven't seen that either. I'm behind. Oh, is Chickenfoot in chat? Oh, he recommended it. That's cool. He watches a lot of anime. You won the battle with the tree? Good job, Kia. I'm so proud of you. Not Ron Swanson, the guy who liked calzones. Ron Swanson's funny too. I also like chewy sweet tarts and regular sweet tarts. I like sour candy in general. Swedish Fish is my jam as well. Oh my God, we're being raided by Perception Studio. How did I miss this? Holy shit. Thank you, Perception Studio. Hi, everybody. I wish I had a really entertaining stream for you, but I'm building a wreath for Christmas. And I also haven't gotten very far with it. But I'm glad you're here. I love Perception Studio. I love puppets. This is not a puppet. This is a real animal. New York style pizza all the way. I like thin crust. I like Warhead candy. We're also talking about stuff that we like. Hi, Media Pluck. Thank you guys for hanging out with me. This is fun. Yelded Cell redeemed. Tell Simone you love him.
Simone, Yelded Cell loves you.
These are fun. Wreath progress 1%. He's basically a Muppet. All right, let's get some more of this wreath done. I like Terraria too. And Rashida Jones. This is fun. We're just saying things that we like now. So basically what I'm doing is I'm finding like a piece that I like. I like Whoppers. I haven't had a Whopper in a very, very long time. I used to drink a lot, or drink. I used to drink a lot more Whoppers than I do now. I used to eat fast food a little bit more, but I've really cut it out. I also didn't grow up with fast food. My mom would not have it. We had home-cooked meals every night. So. And then when I was out on my own, I was like, I'm going fast food nuts. And then I got over it again. Oh my God, weren't the Muppets on the Game Awards so good? Perception Studio would have killed that. Fucking Cucumber giving out an award. And it would have been like this tiny award. My favorite part about having Perception Studio at TwitchCon when they did the singing was they like made tiny little mics for their hands.
It was so fucking cute. It was just like this tiny little attention to detail that I super respected. That little extra TLC. I feel like this wreath is really precarious. Like if you touched it, you might like get stabbed with wire. It's not like I'm putting it on really delicately. Like I'm kind of just slapping it on here. Like it's just getting shoved on there with wire. Your stream died. Oh, that sucks. Yeah, I actually felt the same way with Games for Impact, Jordan Mallory. Like, they basically had this really funny thing, but I wanted them to say, like, which Game for Impact was the most valuable because it's such a wonderful, like, award, and all those people were probably, like, on the edge of their seats, like, did we win or not? But it was still really funny. Untitled Beaker Game. I helped my fiance put a reindeer attached to a sleigh and the reindeer head fell on her back. Jesus, is she okay? It sounds like a rom-com. I feel like I'm not allowed to laugh until we know she's okay. Simone crashed out on the couch while her best friends built a wreath is the best Christmas mood ever. This is pretty much my life. Simone just sleeps there and I do some stupid hobby that no one cares about. I can laugh. Okay, good. Yeah, I'm always back and forth with the Game Awards because I love what it does for the industry, which is celebrate wonderful games, which we should do because there's so many wonderful games and we should celebrate games instead of constantly critiquing them. Here goes my voice. But I also feel that they sell everything. Like, it bothered me that the indie game one was called Which Game Is, like, Subway Fresh. And it was just like, can't you just say Subway sponsored, like, the best indie game of the year? Does it have to be Subway Fresh indie game? It just, like, was too much for me. It was, like, too much sellout. Like, I respect the hustle. But, like, let them just have their moment. Like, they worked really hard. Can they not just get the fucking award without being shilled to, like, they're not getting McDonald's money, right? Like, they're just getting an award. I mean, maybe they are getting McDonald's money. I don't think so, though. So, got little bits. Little wreath bits. Thanks. I think so. Sorry, I'm trying to, like, actually get some wreath done. I recognize it's probably not the most exciting thing, but I should also realize that at some point I should do a wreath on a wreath-making stream. Or not. I could just drink. The cold. This is hard. Do you think this is enough shit? Like, how much shit does it take before it's a wreath? These are the questions, you know? Like, at what point is it done? Reggie had a wonderful speech, and then they kind of, like, hijacked that, too, because he talked about how wonderful games are and how important the industry is. And then it was like an 8-minute ad for Fast and the Furious that looked like dog shit. It was very confusing. Who collected the Fortnite award? I forget. So, it's enough shit. All right, Cell's made the call. Fast the Furious Goaty 2020. Simone, I can see you. Don't you? He's
He's going to go somewhere else and lick his paws, which he knows he's not allowed to do. A little shit. I wish you could smell this. This smells very, like, smells like there's a full Christmas tree in here. It smells really good. Media says it looks full enough as well. I know. What were they thinking? And he was like, we've been gamers forever and we've always wanted to make a game. And it's like, and this is it? Okay. Whatever, man. It was a weird section, and I just felt like it was even weirder because we had just talked about how important games were from Reggie, and everybody loves Reggie, and he can do, like, no wrong. He's a damn saint. So it was like they did this wonderful thing with Reggie, and then they kind of, like, undid it. All right, yeah, I think this is enough crap. So here's my wreath. But we should, like, decorate it with some, like, balls or shit. Can I get some balls in chat? There's only a couple people who can do it. So I got this holly. It's extraordinarily sharp. This holly will fuck you up. Oh, man, nobody's got balls. It's a tier 2 sub, so it's asking for a lot. I think there's only a couple people who have it. Sage, you have balls. Oh my God, he put a little Santa hat on it. That's so cute. It's angry. Wizard's got balls in your faces. It's so sharp. It's like I'm nervous to like hold it. It stabs you. Anyway, I was gonna like cut the balls off. Maybe like here to here and put it on the thing. Monkus. Snap, snap. I don't have winter gloves, but I can hold it at this like butt. Oh, Lord, this isn't going to cut, is it? Do I need, like, a little saw? I am holding it by the butt. These scissors aren't sharp enough. I could get a knife. It's cringy for me too, because I wanna get hurt. It's kind of attacking the base here. Oh, okay, I broke it. Okay. It's like, look how nice it looks. Just like the photos. But these are pointy. Each one of these are like little swords. Okay. Right, we'll cut this part too. It is sharp. You need to be really careful. Holly will mess you up. This is my workstation. I was thinking about, like, just you know, just kind of like tying it to it. Holly Batgirl, that's funny. You had a medical emergency? Wreath end. Everybody's working for the wreath end. If you fold it over the sizzle blade and hold the end, it can't fly into your eyeball when you cut it. That's good advice. I don't know a lot about cutting things, and I think I make a lot of mistakes when I do this. All right, so I'm gonna bend it. I feel like it still flew somewhere. Here it is. I don't think a lot of people do chow. I think I'm doing something a little weird. Thanks, Scorpius. I need a lot of assistance with making sure that this functions properly. Yeah, my scissors are kind of old. I've had them for a while. All right, let's get this holly on here, hey? All right, so my thought is I'm going to put the wire around the holly first. That way I don't have to touch it later because I don't want to deal with it and get stabbed throughout this process. Okay. Okay, so it's connected, and then you just, you know, you just put it on there, right? It can't be that hard. It'll mean more because I made it from scratch. It was also cheaper. The wreaths at the tree farm were, like, I think, kind of expensive. They were $30, which, I don't know, maybe that's normal, but I was like, it's leaves. I'm paying $30 for leaves. That's my mom and me. I'm always like, I just make that. But now look at me. Who's laughing now? And then, does that look good? I don't know. It might need a second piece of wire. It's free real estate. I could make that. I got a new emote. I think I might have gotten two new emotes. I'm gonna look. I have to buy them, but it sucks. The girl who makes some of my emotes, the ones that I really like, the cartoon ones that I'm like really into, she's making a surprise for the stream. I'm really excited about it. I'm so bad with secrets. I'm probably going to end up telling you guys. She's making me a new intro. It's so cute. Well, like a live soon image. It's so cute. It's like my streamer room, and she took some liberties. There's like a bed in there, and I'm laying on there with Simone, and it's so cute. And I love it. She's so talented. She streams too. Her name is Dream. But anyway, I'm pretty sure I have two new emotes, so we can spend those on some fun stuff. I was thinking about doing a Simone butt, but if we have two, we could do another fun one. I could put lights on it, Sel. I wasn't planning on it. I can't help it, Jordan. I'm so bad with secrets. You guys can probably tell that about me. I'm not a good, holes? I could do a holes emote. I'm so bad with secrets. I just like, I have a bad poker face in general. People can tell when I'm hiding something because I'm like this.
Oh no, I dropped it.
I found it.
The lady who did my channel emote was super nice. I need to reach back out to a new emote now that finally hit 15 sub points. Good for you, Silver. It takes so much time. I'm like the same. I feel really impressed that I have like any at all. Man, this is Danger Town is what this is.
Thank you.
Not gonna die today.
Craziest Kiko. Thanks for following.
Cool. This one looks a little thin, actually. Oh, Hellhound, thank you for subscribing with your Twitch Prime for 4 months in a row. Thank you. Thanks for coming back. I really appreciate that, Hellhound. And I like that you used your Prime, because that's smart. Smart, smart. Thank you for supporting the stream. And my video game habit. All right, so here's where we're at. So I have some other decorations. You guys can help me pick which ones you want. I have some ribbon to tie a bow. This is like green ribbon. I have gold kind of see-through ribbon to make a bow. This one's fun. This one is a ho-ho-ho ribbon, but the O is an ornament. That's pretty fun. This is kind of like more, you know, down-home ribbon. The light is not doing it any favors, but it looks like kind of like felt. And I have a ball. Ooh, I do need a hot toddy. I haven't had one yet. I should get a Hollow Knight ribbon. I like that red ribbon. I like the gold. Dread likes red. Cell likes gold. Silver likes gold, ironically. You're gaudy. Is this too gauche? Go with gold, pretty ball, gold. I'm hearing a lot for gold, so let's go with gold because I've heard a lot of it. Use both? I'll fucking use both. I got no qualms about this shit. I like how, thank you guys for participating in this like silly thing. I know it's silly. It's fun though. I wish you could smell it. It smells like a tree. It smells so nice. All right, so you're also gonna learn that I'm really bad at making bows. Also, I never learned how to tie bows like normal people. I don't know loop, swoop, and pull. I know bunny ears, which is stupid. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? So I never learned like this method. I was always, I always learned with two bows and then you tie them. Media pluck, while I was checking the first layer of my 3D print, I accidentally knocked the whole baby Yoda nativity scene on the floor. No. So yeah, bunny ears is different than loop, swoop, and pull. When I was a kid, I like could not figure out how to tie my shoes and I was embarrassed. And I don't remember who it was, frankly, and I should. That's kind of mean of me, but a woman like pulled me aside and was like, just make two bunny ears and tie them. And that's how I tie my shoes and any ties. And I'm very, that's all I do. Dreadful, you save those points and you give Simon love on the next stream. He loves it all the same. I'm winging it. No tutorials. I'm just gonna make it look the way it looks. If it doesn't look as good, then that's the way it be sometimes. Bunny ear shoelaces for life. I mean, that's how I live now. So that's like one. This might be too gaudy. Like, is it too big? Like, maybe the bow should be smaller. I don't know. It's like the... These are like the issues we make. No such thing as too gaudy. Let's gaudy it up. All right, and then so we'll cut it the same length, and I'll have this really awkward amount of ribbon left that will be useless. Oh shit, this bow's a little smaller. Maybe you can, like, can you, like, make these twist or something? A tiny present. So I like it. It's got wire, so it kind of stays the way you fold it. I guess it kind of just looks like garbage. Whatever. That one looks better.
Slay.
Okay, cool. Okay, and then, so, we could put that on the other side. Or should it go on the top? What's more wreath-like? Does it go on the top? Does it go on the top or on the side? Here... Here's what it looks like on the top, and then on the side, I would probably put it on the opposite side of the holly, so it would be like here. I'm reading chat. It goes on the top. Also up to me. All right, cool. I choose top. Okay, I need some wire. This is fun. Oh, I want to drink some booze. Let me put on... Poison ivy. This is me now. Right, I see what you're saying. Bean, you're right. Like, if you have multiple, you can kind of, like, make it asymmetrical, but, like, one giant bow typically goes on top. I'm going to make a hot toddy. I was going to put on a video, but, like, I don't know. You guys can also, I don't know. Do you want to see a video, or would you just hang out? And you can hear me make hot toddy in the background. No ads. No McDonald's ads. That's the only thing. I can just do microphone. All right, I'm just gonna make a hot toddy. You guys can look at my beautiful wreath that we've worked on all stream with no distractions. It's gonna look really good. But I'll put the Christmas tree in there so you can enjoy that too.
Thank you.
All right, I'm gonna make a drink. I'll be right back. They know that Santa's on his way. He's lots of toys and things.
Hey, the Jays. It's going pretty good. Face stream when? I should do it. I have like a lot of anxiety because for having it for as many months as I've had it, I think we're like at 8 months, I don't play it enough. I play it like once a week when you're supposed to play like once a day. So I'm really behind. That being said, I could just do it and just not worry about it. I like the idea of it a lot. Another thing that would be cool was my instructor said he would be comfortable with being on stream with me. And so I was thinking about inviting him and then being like, do you want to do a lesson, but do it on stream? And we'll just like kind of, you know, you'll teach me, and if I suck, like, you know, you're really good and people will enjoy hearing him play. He's amazing. He's phenomenal. He's like classically trained and, you know, he's been playing in bands for his whole life. Once a week. Yeah, I do it once a week. Yeah, I think I just need to like get over the fear. I love Primus. Pork Soda was such a good album. I need wire cutters. I was thinking about doing chill beats with a bass because a lot of chill beats have like really easy bass lines where it's just like dun 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 dun, and it's like I can fucking do that. So I'll just like do something kind of easier. Bristle fry. That was a really fun album. I listened to that going to school, high school.
Days be merry and bright.
Okay, that's with a bow on it. And then my last question is, a little funky. There we go. And then what do you think about the ball? Where did the ball go? I had a ball. So like I could put we went top. Where were you? I asked. It on the bottom. We could put it in the middle. It could just hang in the middle like that. Ball on the bottom. All right. It needs a ball. I thought middle, but I heard a lot for bottom. Middle works. It's your call. You want a little bottom ball. I respect that, though.
Oh, Wizard says that the middle should be open. Bow on the side to balance it out. Sage has got some ideas. These are fresh ideas. These are Subway fresh ideas. Two hidden on the bottom, middle works. It's a dingleberry. It's a dingle hopper. All right, we'll put it on the side like Sagey recommended. Oh my God, I love the sweaty balls bit. I haven't seen it in a really long time. It's so funny. People love my sweaty balls. Oh my God, I have a photo of Simone. If you're serious, I would fucking put up a photo of my dog on anything. I have no qualms. None! No one can resist my sweaty balls. Okay, here's where we're at. So we have... Is that, does it look okay? I think the ball is too low. it looks okay? Looks all right. My first wreath, it's not bad. It's a little full. It looks fine. That's what I think. let me get my photos of my dog. It probably won't work, but I'm gonna look.
Thank you.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary.
Okay, well, I sent them all out. I printed all these photos of my dog and I sent them. I sent them in Christmas cards to people. They're gone. The only thing I found was this photo set of me and Amarice when we went to one of those, like, what would you call that? Like one of those, like, Korean style photo booths. Pika booths or whatever. I can... On the wreath it goes. So... We had a really good time that day. You could put stickers on our faces.
How to Red Cross. It does say how to, and then it's got a red cross. That's true. It's a very strange looking set of photos. They also elongated my body. Like, my body isn't that long. In those types of booths, they like, I think I have camera control. Like, look how long my legs are. And I had to fix everything I just did. Yeah, it like extended my body. And I don't need to be elongated. Like, I'm very happy with how long my body is. Anyway, I couldn't find a picture of Simone, but I could like put that in the middle of it. Hold on one second.